14 centuries ago, one man, a man who was bereaved of his sons, bereaved of his brothers, bereaved of his family members, bereaved of his friends and loyal companions, a man who had been denied food and water, a man for whom the holy prophets of Islam would say, Hussein minni wa ana min al Hussein, Hussein is from me and I am from Hussein. A man by the name of Hussein. Hussein, the son of Ali and Fatima. Hussein, the grandson of the Prophet of Islam. A man who was bleeding from several wounds inflicted on his body. He had lost everything that he had. From early morning, he would bring back the bodies of his loved ones back to his camp. He had even buried his six-month-old infant child. With tears flowing down from his eyes, he looks towards the sky, and from an unseen source, he seems to draw some strength. And then, just like a muazzin from a minaret on the plains of Karbala, on the day of Ashura, he raises his voice. He calls out, Ala hal min nasiri yansurna. Is there any helper that would help me? Is there any supporter that would support me? Is there anyone that would aid the family of Rasulullah? Is there anyone that would aid the children and the women of Rasulullah? He turns his direction. He repeats the call. He does so 4 times. On that day, only a handful had responded to that call. However, if we take a look around the world today, we see there are millions around the world that respond to the call of Aba Abdullah al-Hussein with their slogan of Labbaik Ya Hussein. There are millions around the world that are learning lessons from the sacrifice of Aba Abdullah al-Hussein with their motto being Labbaik Ya Hussein. There are millions around the world that are crying for Aba Abdullah al-Hussein with tears flowing down from their cheeks. They're chanting, Labbaik Ya Hussein. There are millions around the world that are mourning for Aba Abdullah al-Hussein, continuously humming, united and in unison, Labbaik Ya Hussein. If we take a look around the world today, we see that the name of Aba Abdullah al-Hussein is alive not in thousands, but millions of households around the world, each with their slogans, chanting loud and clear, Labbaik Ya Hussein. There are millions around the world that are flocking towards the masajids and towards the Husseiniyas, each united and in unison within their hearts, chanting, Labbaik Ya Hussein. There are millions around the world that are flocking towards his shrine, paying their respects, paying their allegiance to him, again chanting the slogan of Labbaik Ya Hussein. May we all continue to chant united and in unison through our words and also through our actions, Labbaik Ya Hussein, Labbaik Ya Hussein, Labbaik Ya Hussein. This year, we will be fortunate to come once again to commemorate the tragedy of Aba Abdullah al-Hussein. We'll be gathered to remember the calamities that befell upon Aba Abdullah al-Hussein. However, if we are ready to truly remember the sacrifice of Aba Abdullah al-Hussein, if we are truly ready to cry for him, one thing is for certain is that we must ask ourselves, we must diagnose ourselves and ask that question, how is it that I'm going to remember my master this year? How is it that I'm going to cry for him? We must decide and establish that this year, when I cry for my master Hussein alayhi salam, when I mourn for him, when I remember his tragedy, I will do so with ma'rifah. I will have Hussein within my heart. I will make sure that my actions are also Husseini, so that my whole body is Husseini from its limbs and from its spirit. And truly will I then be chanting, Labbaik Ya Hussein, Labbaik Ya Hussein, Labbaik Ya Hussein.